everybody. Welcome to the Teacher Allie's Cooking Class. Happy Cinco de Mayo. In the spirit of Cinco de Mayo, we are going to make some nachos today. So, I have some cheese, some ground turkey, salsa, sour cream, some barbecue sauce, tomatoes, more cheese. I have refried beans, some taco seasoning, some green onions, and chips. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn the oven on over here to 375. And I have my cookie sheet here, so we're gonna lay our nachos here. This is for our meat and beets. All right, so pop this open. Just gonna pour it out here. We're just gonna do the whole bag. That might be a little much. You can take a little bit away, but most of the bag. Maybe take a little more away. Okay. Okay. Perfect. So I'm gonna put some cheese on and then I'm gonna stick it in the oven while I start my meat and beans. And then we're gonna do a second layer of cheese because we love cheese. Cheese. You could also use queso too if you're not doing this first layer, or if you prefer. All right, that looks like a pretty good first layer here. So let's pop it in the oven, and then we're gonna start our meat. All right. So I got some ground turkey here. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of olive oil in the skillet to start. And then I have my meat here. I'm gonna use this barbecue sauce. Love this barbecue sauce. And then I have a little taco seasoning. There we go. We are in business. Okay. So I have it on medium heat right now. That should be good. And all right, I got my turkey, my salsa seasoning. Over here, but those take about 2 minutes, so I'm gonna wait on those right now. But you could do black beans or any kind of beans that you prefer. Or if you don't eat meat, I used, when I did this with the kids at school, I did a quinoa-based meat, and that was really good, and really easy to cook. I cooked really fast, so that's a great alternative. Or you could just do wings. Beans and just throw them in the pot. Multitasking. Having a little problem here, but we'll make it through. There we go. Okay. We're just struggling tonight, but that's all right. It's all good. So, dump this in here. Okay, I can hear my meat sizzling, which is great. Okay. I got beans all over my hands now, so I'm just gonna do a little wash. And peek at the nachos inside there. Oh, cheese is melting, that looks great. I'm gonna just leave it in there for one more minute. Okay, my meat is starting to color. Some hot pads. Cheese looks great. You know, I'm gonna leave it in for one more minute because the middle doesn't look completely melted. And we have some time. Seasoning and barbecue sauce. As soon as we get a little more of that red color out. I'm just going to prep some while I have a minute. Okay, so I'm going to use probably two of these green onions here. Get rid of the slimy parts. I'm gonna rinse them, and I'm gonna rinse some tomatoes. So let's get all of this. Rinse some tomatoes, and then we have to take the nachos out of the oven. All the cheese is melted now. So I'm just gonna leave this here to cool for a minute. Our meat is looking great. Almost time to add in some of our seasoning. This is just green onion. You can use whatever kind of onion you would like. Tomatoes in half. Some people are not as fond of tomatoes in my house, so I'm only going to cut some for myself right now. No tomatoes and no avocado, which are probably some of my two favorite things, but got some picky eaters out there. Let's go check our meat. That looks great. I think it's time to add our seasoning. All right, so let's do some taco seasoning. This is just regular taco seasoning mix. Oh, sorry, premium. And then I'm gonna do some barbecue sauce. Perfect. And mix it all together. You can also add salsa if you like to mix sometimes. That is looking great. I think we are almost ready to turn this off.
cook our beans really quick and get our toppings all situated. Keep my beans. Let me just use more here. Perfect. Alright, so we're just gonna heat these. It just takes a minute here. So while those are heating, I got some sour cream over here and avocado and then some salsa. Myself. Yum. All right, let's get a spoon just to stir. Oh, here, I have my little spatula here for my beans. Stir that around. Take a minute while that is heating. I'm gonna go ahead and put some meat on my chips here. Around so everybody gets a little meat. Our beans should be done in just a minute. You can hear them. Yeah, they look pretty good. You can see the steam coming off of them. I think that's about done. So turn that off. These are a little more difficult to spread than the meat. Let's go get our spatula. Gotta get all the beans. All right. Now we are going to put some more cheese on top and put it in for just another minute. While we prep the rest of the toppings. Cheese. All throw it back in the oven for a few minutes so we get the cheese to melt again. And let's get back to the rest of our prepping. So, I will put some of this stuff in bowls now. Grab a spoon for my sour cream. Add in the bowl too. Perfect. And I'm just gonna add this. Alright. So these should be done. We're just gonna let the cheese melt. If you can see, we're almost there. I just want the cheese a little more melted and ready to eat. So I'm gonna grab a plate here. I'll show you. I'm gonna dish my nachos for myself. I had a little beans bowl. That looks amazing. And my chips are a little bit crispy, which I like too. So for my plate, let's see which one is the cheesiest. I think I'm gonna go with this one. Try and gracefully scoop this up. Perfect. All right. And let's go over here. I'm going to add some green onions. That's yum. And a little avocado. Yes, I'm using my hands. But don't worry, I washed them. And some tomato. Maybe a little more tomato. And a little dollop. That's a big dollop. Of sour cream on top. And these are my delicious Cinco de Mayo nachos. I hope you all have a great holiday, and I will see you next cooking class.